Oasis is here. We finally arrived at the Oasis, says McBean. To tell you the truth, this is my birthplace. It's as empty as I remember it to be. Anyway, there was a sign of a residence stone around here, but the question is, where? Nothing much to see here, is there? Well, Grandpa Mac, not exactly. Looks like this place is full of life, on the other hand, says Forte. Okay, there's a few people. Some shops, a weapon shoppy. A whole bunch of shops, yeah. I'm getting a little aerial tour. What's this? Says McBean. When the heck did such a bazaar open? Are you talking about the bazaar in Ostern? Says Ada. It's pretty famous these days. When I came here 10 years ago during the tour, there was nothing here. Did this start recently? What a turnaround from such a desolate land. Let's take a break, Grandpa. It's too hot, and I'm exhausted. Squeak! Without the U. I guess it's a skeek. You totally ruined my nostalgia, says McBean. It must have been too much for you guys to travel Ostern under the scorching sun since this is your first time. Let's take a rest while collecting information at the inn. Inn? I thought there were just these vendors outside. Trade items. Is this... It usually says buy, doesn't it? Well... Yeah, we're buying it. Alright. So there's a... I thought we'd be trading our item for, like, you know, something else for the red bandana, but I see the price there. 500 roses. Oh, well, they have it in roses. Exchange. What are we exchanging? Exchange rills to gents. Oh, well, they only selling in roses here. Right? They're all ours. A resurrect ring? Ring impregnated with resurrect potion. Wear it and you'll be revived once. It was impregnated with a potion. Happy key ring. Beautiful amethyst key ring that makes you happy and increases critical rate. Hairpin. Fashionable spiraling hair accessory. You'll feel driven. Increases spell power. White ring. Beautiful snow white ring that twinkles. Increases protection against spells. Flip cape. Fashionable cape made by suede. Whips off attacks to increase your defense. These are all like accessories. Well, it really helps Jan and Rick with attack and defense. Bandana of sharp red color. Refreshes your mind, increasing your attack power. I'll get it for Jan and Rick. Oh, then we have to take off. What does this do? I don't know what the economy ring does. Wish you could find out without having to take the thing off. Ring with fragrant olive smell. Wear it and you'll feel calm. Saves magic points. Oh well. We took that off. Fortune teller says, glad you came. I'll foretell your destiny. However, I ask you 100 gent for the fee. Sure. The fortune teller took out a bundle of bamboo sticks. Rolling them together, What you should do now is to heal your tired body. If you're mentally tired, you'll easily lose your path to follow. Okay. We're gonna do that anyway. Let's just see if this... Okay. Making sure this is the south edge. Nothing else down there. Is the item shop guy? See, now it says buy instead of trade. If you use roses, I guess it's trade. What's the thing we have that's... we only have one of? I mean, two of. Tranquil? Yeah, anti-panic. We need some more of that. How about one lackety paste and two tranquil snuffs? Okay. It's a person. Oh, I don't want to leave. Enid is south. He won't let us leave, I'm sure. McBain says, the resonance stone should be somewhere in this oasis. That's our first priority. Where might it be, though? Is it going to be the darkness or firestone? Either way, there should be some kind of clue somewhere. Basara says, what do you think of the bazaar? This place is so full of energy. You can find anything from all over the world here. We are proud of our selection of goods here in Astern. Okay. So we came from there. Antique dealer. Come and take a look at it. I've got very rare stuff from all over the world. How about a doll from the one and only Rosette's Workshop? Huh. From Rosette's Workshop, says Una? I didn't expect to find something like that here. Yes, I'm pretty sure, says Ada. This is my grandpa's piece of work. Really? Are you Maestro Rosette's granddaughter? Your grandfather's dolls are well received here. Haha, really? Take your time and look around. You may be able to find something rare. You never know. We can't look at anything. Everything is on sale, from newly cut gemstone to beautifully decorated rings. Please take time and look around. Wow, beautiful, says Una. Definitely. So cool, Ada says. Really? Says Forte. Gems are the principal product of Astern. Isn't it kind of exciting to imagine that there are colorful gems under such bad desert? Can't actually buy any. Shoe Sign Furio says, hey, mister. Let me shine your shoes. I only charge 10 gen. Sure. Well, okay, says Forte. Alright. First of all, put on shoe cream and... Squeak, squeak. The boy gave Forte's shoes a good shine. Now, they look all better. They look like brand new. Good job, says Forte. Hey, of course, I'm a professional. Look how shiny they are. Huh. Perina says, the reason why this bazaar is so prosperous is because the big boss in the oasis has been working very hard on it. The boss is pretty hot, but the bartender who was recently hired at the bar is pretty cool. One's hot, one's cool? Okay. That goes out. That goes to Selbart. Okay. The peddler says, "This bazaar is jumping with life. Since the Numero started their invasion, the roads and sea routes have been blocked, but the bazaar is still going strong. I bet it's because the boss of this bazaar is on top of everything." You bet, huh? A trader says, "Someone like me who grew up in a northern country can't take this heat. That's why I drink cold drinks too much. I could get a stomach ache if I'm not careful. Just drink water. Best thing for you." And salt too. Electrolytes if you've been sweating, but I don't know if they know about electrolytes here. Oh, I'm gonna talk to him last. Uni says, "Hi, welcome. Are you newcomers? Is this your first time here at the bazaar?" McBain says, "I stopped by once 10 years ago, but there was nothing here back then." Uni says, "The market started 5 years ago. What do you say? It's changed a great deal, hasn't it?" "Yeah, I like this energy." "Make yourself at home. If you want to order something, go to the counter." Alright, this is just to stay new. Yeah, I'm talking to him last. It is the way of things. Is this... I talk to you? Oh. "If you want your shoes shine, leave it to me. I may look young, but I've been doing this for a long time." Oh. There is a little literal oasis here. Was a weapon shop. Nothing new, huh? That's okay. Yeah, nothing new. Get to save our money. Try to get a little more money next time. Cloth shop. "This fabric is from Literatuto. What do you think? Look at this use of color. It's a masterpiece." McBain says, "This is Kranka weaving." "How do you know?" asks Ada. Una says, "Kranka weaving uses shells of Reiko's palma as a dye." Oh, I remember that. That was like one of our first quests or something. We had to get dye for the old lady. Someone's grandma. It wasn't our grandma. Maybe Una's grandma? "Una might have made the dye out of this fabric," says Forte. "Wow, what a coincidence," says Ada. "I see. The color was from the shells. That made me want to go visit Reiko's Palma at least once in a lifetime." "Please come visit," says Forte. "I'm sure you'll love it." Okay, so this is where we came in, more or less. Right? Yeah. Just want to make sure I don't miss any of these shops. Fruit dealer says, "Everything's cheap here. I've got watermelons, pomegranates, oranges, bananas, papayas, and coconuts. A variety of exotic fruits you can rarely find." "Wow, they look delicious," says Una. "Hold your appetite till we get to the bar," says McBain. "How about it, old man? I also got some figs, too." "Oh, I'm not used to seeing those." "Grandpa, hold your appetite. I've got watermelons, pomegranates, oranges, bananas, papayas, and coconuts." Here, you said that. Okay. Oh, he's got meat cooking stuff on the grill. Stall. "How about that? They look delicious, don't they?" Savory smells started to hang in the air with a sizzling sound. "Wow. What's it called?" asked Forte. "Shish kebab. It's roasted mutton on a skewer. Would you like one? It's just cooked." "Looks good," says Una, "but can I have something to drink first?" "I serve not only shish kebab, but also bread and sheep cheese." Okay, those are not drinks. "They are very tasty." She wants a drink first. Are you people deaf? Anything around here? There's a... Oh. Oh, wow. We got a ruined... home. What's left of a house? Forte says, wow, it's falling apart. McBain, very quiet all of a sudden. Is this, like, his home? He said this was his, hometown. So maybe this was his old home? This doesn't want to say right now. Interesting. That's all that's up here, huh? Maybe we could play a performance up there for them. It's like a... could be used as a stagey kind of area. Alright, let's talk to this guy. He's the last one. As far as I know. The bartender says, welcome. What can I get for you? Get these children a glass of cold coconut milk, says McBean. I'd like coconut beer. Huh? Is there anything wrong? Asks Forte. No. Nothing, says the bartender. Coconut beer and coconut milk, right? I'll be right at your table. Don't tell me this stuff, like, went bad and he's afraid to say we're all gonna get sick. Forte and his friends quenched their thirst with a cold drink. Phew! Delicious, says Ada. It's such a luxury to have a cold drink when it's hot, says Una. Anyway, we took a brief break, so let's go look for the resonance stone, McBean says. According to the magic map, it must be somewhere in this oasis. Is there any cave or something around here? Asks Forte. There's no cave here. We're not sure that the resonance stone is in a cave, though. Then it's possible that a merchant has it, says Forte. Ada says, sometimes quite a find can be sold at this kind of bazaar. A resonance stone can be sold here, too. Yeah, anything can happen, says Una. Let's give it a try, says McBean. In the meantime, let's pay a visit to all of the street stalls. Alright, we already did, but I'll do it again. It's an old house behind the bar. It's been deserted quite a while. I wonder if anyone used to live in that old house. McBain. How'd you like the drink? It was pretty good, wasn't it? Yeah, it was great, says Forte. Good deal. By the way, aren't you guys here to shop at the bazaar? McBain says, we were in the middle of a tour, but we've got some business to take care of and look for something. We're planning to go look at around the street stalls. I see. You should be able to find pretty much anything you want here at the bazaar. Hope you can find what you're looking for. What was the issue with the coconut milk and another old house behind the bar. Behind this bar. Unless over here means behind the bar. Let me go back over there, see if, now McBain might say. So this is not behind the bar. No, he won't say anything. You can't walk behind it over there, anyway. Alright, we'll go look around the stalls again. It's the only house here. Well, other than the inn. The only buildings. Okay. We'll talk to all the people again, too. I bought a bolt of Cranker weaving from Letteratudo. I'm so excited to just think what I'm gonna make. I sell fabric. Sorry, but I don't deal with stones. Why don't you try the jewelry store? Technically, there are stones there. A stone? I've never seen anything like that. I only deal with fruits. How about this watermelon? You may be able to find the stone inside of it. You never know. Just kidding. There's no watermelon with a stone in it. Ha ha ha. Yeah, you're funny. A stone with a music score carved in it. Never heard of it. Anyhow, how about sheep cheese? It's good and nutritious. A stone? What does it look like? It's about the size of a palm, says Forte. A music score is carved on the back. It's very specific. Sorry, but I don't have it. A stone, huh? I don't see stores around here which deal with stones. A stone with words carved in it? Oh yeah, I have it. Really? Says Forte. The trader took out a marble seal. I'll carve the name as you wish. It's a seal for good luck. Just take a look at it. It's pretty nice, isn't it? Well, sorry, but this is not what we are looking for, says Una. Sorry I wasn't much of help. You were not much of help. Well, he's not gonna answer my questions. Nor will he. No. Come again. If Furio is here, I'll have him polish my shoes. The downside is that even though I get my shoes polished, they will get dirty soon because Ostern is in a desert. I just love the feeling the moment when my shoes are just shined. Let me just get a little sandal over them again, huh? Oh, we have a exclamation mark. I thought it was him, though, we wanted to talk to. I'm dealing with a variety of stones. What kind of stone are you looking for? It's about the size of a palm, says McBean. A music score is carved on the back. A stone with a carved music score. A girl next door is selling antiques. She may know something about it better than I do. A stone? What does it look like? It's palm size, says McBean. And hold on 1 second. Yeah. A music score is carved on the back. It sounds like more of a stone discovered in the ruins than an antique. Ruin? Is there a ruin around here? Asked Forte. There are some ancient underground ruins to the west of Selbart. The villagers don't welcome outsiders, so I don't know much about it. But I heard there is a slate on which ancient letters are carved. Either way, our store doesn't carry it. Sorry I wasn't much help. Thank you anyway, says Una. Wait here. I heard that the big boss of the bazaar had found something rare recently. I'm pretty sure it was a small stone. That's it, says Ada. Where would the big boss be? He owns a bar. He may be over there. Oh, the bartender again? The bartender at the bar is pretty hot. Yeah. Because it's a desert. He's a lot of fun, but at the same time, he is down to earth and refined. He got hired recently. Now I'm a big fan. I don't think I'm less refined than that man, says McBean. Why are you competing with him? Says Forte. If you want to know about the boss, ask the bartender. A stone with a carved music score. Oh, yeah. Same. Anyone else to talk to? A small stone? I have a pumice stone for polishing shoes. That's about it. The boy showed his pumice stone for shoe shining to Forte and his friends. Interesting, says Ada. It's so fragile. You scrub shoes with insistent dirt with the stone. I see, says Forte. But it's not the one we're looking for. If you're looking for a stone, why don't you try it at the jewelry store? Or maybe an antique store? Yeah, done that. Have you seen the bartender here? It's pretty hot. Yeah. Hello, Mr. McBean. Have you finished shopping at the bazaar? What did he just say? As Forte whispers. Listen, Mr. Bartender, says Ada. Do you know where the big boss of the bazaar might be? The boss is out now. Or the boss is out now. He is on a business trip and won't come back for a while. Bad timing, says Ada. What should we do now? Excuse me, says Forte. How do you know my grandpa's name? What? Why are you asking me that? I only call him Grandpa. I call him Grandpa Mac. I call him Mr. Mac, says Ada. See? No one calls him McBain. Oops. You got me good. Now you know. What's going on here? Asks Ada. Mr. McBain, your grandson is very sharp, isn't he? Long time no see, says McBain. I didn't expect to see you here. Do you know him, Grandpa? Why, you knew I was suspicious, but didn't know who I was. Forte, don't you remember your comrade who defeated the pirates together? Ag? Mr. Slade. That's not even his real name, says Una. No, you are a fake diplomat, Slade, right? Fake Slade. Was it obvious I was fake? After we parted ways in Polka, we met the real Mr. Slade, says McBean. Well, bad deeds are revealed any time. I still don't get it, asks Ada. Explain to me in a way I can understand. I see. But why are you here in the desert, Mr. Fake Diplomat? Would you mind not calling me that? Then what's your real name, asks Forte. Helon Fred. Helon Fred? It's secret, but I'm a con man. All those books are about him, then. The Adventures of Fred the Con Man. Con man, says Ada. Ah, no, shh, says Fred. Don't raise your voice. In my way, I'm a righteous con man. Righteous, says Una. Con man, asks Forte. I don't think the word righteous and con man go together. No, they don't, says Ada. Don't you think so? Says Fred. Maybe not. I won't deceive hard-working people, but I target the rich people who run corrupt businesses or evil aristocrats. That's why you sneaked into the party at Riatam Island, says Una. That's right. Just so you know, I'm working as a bartender for money, not for a bad purpose. Much is owed to the boss here. I'm doing this in return for his kindness. By the way, says McBain, we heard that your boss has obtained quite a find recently. Have you heard anything about that? Quite a find, huh? Come to think of it, he was polishing some kind of stone before he left. It was about palm size and some kind of characters are carved on it. That's it, says Forte. Everyone says palm size. But I don't know when he comes back, so you need to wait till he does. Grandpa. Then we should go to Selbart first. You're right, says McBain. We don't have time to just sit around and wait for him. Done deal, says Fred. I'm gonna go get ready then. What? Says Forte. Mr. Slade, correction. Are you coming too, Fred? Asks Una. I've heard that there were some underground ruins. In fact, I was always interested in it. But Selbart is famous for its seclusion. They won't tell anything to the outsiders. I have a feeling that you will be able to make friends with them, so if I tag along with you guys, I may be able to get into the ruins. Do you think we can trust him? Asks Ada. A little suspicious, but I don't think he's a bad person, Una says. Forte says, you said you were interested in ruins. Do you mean you're targeting the treasures there? No way, That's Bandit. I'm purely interested in the ruins. There must be some kind of fate that we met here, says McBain. I have no objection. All right, then. Hey, Uni. What, Fred? I'm going to take them to Selbart. Can you watch the bar for me? Okay. You owe me big. Let's head to Selbart. Fred joins the party. So we've got all these books. The Flamboyant Adventure of Fred the Con Man. They must have been about him. So now we get to walk around and talk to everybody again. Except for people who don't say anything. Selbart's dance is very passionate, like a fire butterfly dancing. I wish I could dance like that. They say that there's an underground ancient ruin to the west of Selbart. I bet they can make good money on tourism, but the people there don't like that kind of thing. What a waste. I wonder why the people of Selbart dislike outsiders. Move down. There are ferry boats running between the port of Enid in the south to the port of Gezalg in Numerous Empire, but they have been cancelled since the invasion started. Okay. I'm just gonna systematically work our way back. Let's talk to this one wandering person. She didn't say anything new. Surprised about that. I've got Cranka Weaving from Letteratudo. It's on sale now. Fresh and juicy, good and delicious. Try some tropical fruits. You may not have much appetite because of this heat, but still you better eat something. If you're hungry, you'll run out of gas quickly. Oh yeah? Run out of gas? Ah, Uncle Fred. Hey, I'm too young to be called Uncle. How's your shoe shining job going? Doing pretty good. Making good money. I'll be able to buy a present easily. Present? Asked Una. My sister's birthday is coming up soon. I want to get her a hair accessory. He's a good brother to his little sister, says Ada. Hee hee. As soon as I make money enough to buy her a hair accessory, I'll quit being a shoe shiner and go back to Enid. You're literally just doing it for that. Okay. He's so hot. Yes, well, it's a desert. Fred is out now? I wanted to have a drink with him, though. Fred, I just remembered I have to return the book I borrowed from you. I've already read that book, so you can keep it for a while. Fortane, do you want to read it? Fortane and his friends received Doll Knight 18. Sweet, are you sure? Asked Fortane. Young people should read a lot, says Fred. You're right, thanks. Cool. Four more to get. Hi, Fred. Are you done working today? Too bad. I was going to get some drinks tonight. Come see me again. I'll give you good service. If you're not working, I'll come back sometime again. If Furio is here, I'll have him polish my shoes. He is here. The downside is, though... Oh, I already read that. I read it. Item shop. Fortune teller. Come again. Is that it? Is that everybody? You want to try that house one more time? See if he says anything this time? I don't know. Nope. Alright. So, it's to the west. Just want to see... Well, it looks like you can walk out on the edge of that. No. Yeah, I want to see what he says if we try to go to the other town. Enid, because it's supposed to go into its cell bar. Oh, just lets us. I'm surprised it lets us. Okay. Doesn't even say cell bar. Oh, because they're so private, these people. They don't even have it on the sign, I bet. Anyway, that'll be next episode. I'll head over there and then try to find this dungeon. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.